Casey Anthony free this morning after almost 3 years in jail. Anthony was released soon after midnight Eastern time. She had been acquitted of murdering her 2-year-old daughter, Kaylee, 12 days ago. And as of now, her whereabouts are known by only a few. Anthony's release is an emotional event for many people around the country who are just surprised and angered by the not guilty verdict. And what happens next in this ongoing drama is a big concern for millions who watched her trial. We may gain some perspective by taking a look back. NBC's Jay Gray joins me in the newsroom with that part of the story. Good morning to you, Jay.
Good morning to you, Richard. Yeah, as we saw throughout this trial and early this morning with her release, Casey Anthony has touched an emotional chord across the country. And as unique as this case may seem to be, there is actually a bit of history that may provide some insight into what comes next.
As Casey Anthony walked out of the Orange County jail, she followed in the footsteps of a group of high-profile defendants whose freedom has captured the attention,
not guilty,
and emotions
justice for Kaylee
of the country.
There are many people who identify with the victims or even with the witnesses, and they feel very strongly about it, and it really becomes very passionate to them.
Not guilty of the crime of murder.
But what about those accused and acquitted once the focus shifts to the next courtroom drama? O.J. Simpson is currently serving time in a Nevada state prison convicted of numerous felonies, including kidnapping and armed robbery. Michael Jackson fought rumors and allegations until his death 2 years ago. Two of the four Los Angeles police officers involved in the Rodney King incident wound up spending time in federal correction camps.
Not guilty of the crime of first-degree murder of Bonnie Lee.
Robert Blake, acquitted in the murder of his wife, was ruled liable for her wrongful death in a civil suit.
We find the defendant not guilty.
William Kennedy Smith, acquitted of criminal rape charges in 1991, is a doctor now. A civil sexual assault allegation by a co-worker was dismissed in 2005. And after being found not guilty by reason of temporary insanity, and now a mom, even Lorena Bobbitt, cut a nerve with so many who followed her trial.
It often makes people a lot more cynical and skeptical about the system.
No justice served today.
Part of an effect that often lasts long after the verdict.
And now with the internet, now it really doesn't go away, because now you just Google it. And you could put in murder or famous trials or acquittals, and you get all the information as if it happened yesterday.
Or this morning.
And I want her to be able to grieve and grow and somehow get her life back together.
Casey Anthony perhaps taking a step out of the spotlight for the first time in 3 years. But the emotion and passion from her trial, like the others before her, is not likely to fade for quite some time. And back live now. Yeah, Richard, as we've talked about, there was emotion out there outside the jail this morning. It's something that's not likely to go away for quite some time, which is one reason perhaps that her attorneys want her to stay out of the spotlight.
Yeah, we will see. Jay Gray, everybody, as you have been saying and reporting for us, want to know what she will do next. Jay.